All right, everybody, let the games begin. Here we are back in Palm Springs in this Beechcraft 1900 Delta. It's your boy Dre, not live anymore. Been having some internet issues, even though it seems to work out fine, so I don't know if it's the settings of my OBS or not, but nonetheless, I can't stream on a regular basis anyway, so I'm gonna start doing some more videos where I can do the videos, just because I like putting new content on the channel and keeping you guys entertained while doing what I love to do, flying and driving trucks. So today we're flying this Beechcraft 1900 Delta for private charters. We're headed from Palm Springs to Oxnard, which subsequently there's a shortage in my trucking company, so I need to drive a load. So we're gonna get to Oxnard and take a load in some type of truck somewhere. We'll figure that out once we land, but in the meantime, let's stay on schedule. We are on pilot edge, ready to board this aircraft, power's on, but other than that, we have not done much else. So let's go ahead and jump on board today. All right, we've got the plane on, and now we need to go ahead and call for our clearance and do the rest so that we can get airborne. So without further ado, I'm gonna go ahead and shut this music off. Let's just go and take a look at what we got here for as far as radio frequencies, and then we'll get this music shut down. All right, we have the music shut down here. Let's see, 19.7, that's definitely not the frequency, so let's pull the right one up. This plane is originally supposed to have the Reality GTN 750 interface with it as well. However, they didn't upgrade it, so here's what we're doing today. So here's all of our frequencies. We're using our Navigraph, of course. There's our wonderful airplane on the ramp at the Signature Aviation fuel box. And of course, there's our clearance, so you guys know we'll be sharing some information along the way. So let's go ahead and type in our clearance frequency of 128.35. So let's make that happen, and then we'll get the radios turned on. Flight plan is already filed, so 128.35 is clearance, and then ground is going to be 1219. So we can might as well go ahead and get that all set up, and then we'll start doing our other frequencies. Let's come back up top here, of course, and turn that off. And before I turn that on, let me check a couple, see what views I have in this aircraft. There we go. All right, I won't be pausing my track IR a whole bunch today either. Just simply because,
find view ID 12.
Okay, we'll leave it right here while we call for clearance, of course. Palm Springs clearance, number 350 Kilo Tango, IFR Oxnard. Ah, it might help if we actually had the radio COM 1 turned on, so just kidding. Let's try that again.
Ground Cessna 58 Charlie, ready
to take punch.
Information uniform from Signature Support.
Number 58 Charlie, then I have Hound, runway 16 right, taxi via Alpha Charlie.
16 right, via Alpha Charlie, 58 Charlie.
Palm Springs clearance, November 350 Kilo Tango, IFR Oxnard.
On request, stand by.
All right, so we are on request, standing by. We are using a tech route, so it should be technically those. You could pretty much fly those without necessarily worrying about the filing, as long as you know what the tech route is. In the Southern California airspace, it's very busy, so in the meantime, not really much we can do, because I don't want to start the engines and burn any fuel until it's time to do so. Let me figure out what setting this was. Okay. All right. So we'll be using this setting here and off for static one, since I won't be turning off the track IR. In the meantime, let's see what else we can set up around the aircraft. Let's work on our lighting until he comes back. Okay. We'll turn the nav light on. Not much else, because
Number 350 Tango clearance, you're clear to the Oxnard Airport by the Cathedral 1 departure. The Palm Springs VOR, then I've filed. Maintain 7,000, expect 12,000, 10 minutes after departure. Departure frequency 126.7, squawk 5612.
Cleared to Oxnard as filed, Cathedral 1, Palm Springs transition. Climb 7,000, expect 12,000, 10 minutes after departure. Departure frequency is 26.7, squawking 5612, November 350 Kilo Tango.
November 0 Kilo Tango, read that correct.
All right. So, let's go ahead and shut them down for now. And let's get this flight plan in there really quick because that's going to be the easiest thing to do. So, let's just click this. We got the old school one in here. So, we can go ahead and immediately load the procedure. We're going to be loading a departure, of course. Cathedral 1. Departure. And let's see here. In the meantime, so it's not too drab and dry in here. Let's continue on our music endeavors here. So let's go ahead and select runway 31 left. And we already have Palm Springs as a transition, so we're going to go ahead and enter that. And then I believe after Palm Springs, it's going to be D-Way. Let me check the old rusty dusty flight plan, of course. And it is actually an airway to D-Way, but this doesn't do airway, so D-Way is going to be good enough for us to go direct PSP to D-Way. So let's get that programmed in while we listen to some tunes here. Keep it super simple here. Anyway, I hope everybody's doing well, staying safe as well, not to mention the pandemic situation is getting better, even though we got to be smart about how we operate. So let's keep that in mind. Well, that's my well wishes for you all. All right, I believe this is Pomona, P-O-R, P-O-M. I believe that's Pomona. I'm correct. If not, I'll do a few push-ups for you guys for being incorrect there. All right, so there is, drum roll, Pomona. Perfect. Yes, that's U.S. Southeast. Yes, we want to accept that. And then we're going to do Van Nuys. Promise you this isn't going to take long. Then we'll get up and out of here and taxi away. Get the ATIS while the aircraft is starting up. There we are. And then, of course, we are going to go to Van Nuys. I know, guys, slow going on this thing, but you know, sometimes we got to take a step back from technology and get a taste of how sometimes it can be when everything is not so doggone convenient. This is one of those situations there, simply because you got to scroll through this Fillmore. That's the one. And then we're going direct, so then now we can look for Oxnard. Almost there, I promise you. Hopefully it just recognizes the X, like there's nothing else except Oxnard. But there you go, I got them wrong. Apparently KOXB is another little airport there. So let's find that R so we can get to where we need to go and stop messing with these knobs. Oxnard, booyah, accept. Now, I pretty much know this airport. So what we're going to do is we're always going to set up this approach, even though it may change. So let's do a procedure here. We are going to select an approach, hit enter. We're going to select the ILS 25 and we're going to do it from, let's see, we could do it from Van Nuys. Fillmore is actually past Van Nuys. Because if we go all the way up to Fillmore, basically you got to turn back around. So let's us punch in Van Nuys here and go from there. Actually, you know what? Let's type in Fillmore, which will still include Van Nuys. Then we could go direct in the actual flight plan. So if we take a look at flight plan here, this is the normal flight plan. And then here, Fillmore. So you see it still skips Van Nuys. So we'll have to see how that works out. If not, we'll get to Van Nuys up here. Then we can go direct this Kudak, and that'll put us on the approach as well. Because Fillmore is way out of the way. As you can see, the degrees heading, Fillmore is going to be a, you know, basically a northeastern heading. The other ones are going to be basically straight in until we need to make the turn to Hoopla. So we'll check all that out. But in the meantime, this looks good. And of course, we'll have some radio navigation that we can set up, or VNAV, I should say, we could set up in it. But right now we don't need to. So let's just keep the flight plan going here. We're not going to hit the CDI yet because the aircraft has not even started yet. So without further ado, now we can shut the music back off. And the last thing we need to do is come here. We can also use this function here. Let's put in our ATC code, of course, and make it happen so that we're not belaboring the putting that in and potentially forgetting that later. So our ATC code was 5612. Okay, so we'll go ahead and just put that in there. Now we still have to turn the transponder on. Our departure is already 1267, which is in there, and 12465, I believe, is the ATIS already, so we're good there. So we basically have our ATIS and our frequencies programmed here. We just need to put the other one on tower and switch over from that. So we're able to go ahead and get ATIS while we're starting aircraft up. So let's get the first engine going, and then we should turn the ATIS on so we can get everything taken care of. So in the meantime, let's double check a few things here. Let's get this up and out of the way. Let's get this up and out of the way. And of course, we're going to start buttoning up the door. So let's get the cockpit door closed, of course. And we are also going to close the outside doors. Oops, wrong one. Let's use this interface here and close the passenger door and the baggage door. And then there are glitches in the game, so let's go out and just double check that that is all buttoned up, which it is. Back into the aircraft. Now we can go ahead and get our beacon on since the aircraft is about to become active. And parking brake is set. Those are up. Let's make sure both prop areas are clear. And that is the case. So now we can sneak right through here. We're going to turn on the engine ignition, of course. And before we do that, let's go ahead and take our condition levers out of the feather, which works on the angle of the blades. And we'll go for a start, and we'll go monitor that engine as if we have our first officer in here, which is really you. All right, you can see those blades, the pitch change, which is pretty cool how they did that. We've got some rotation there. That pitch changed. All right, and that turbine is coming up. Okay, we'll release the start switch there. All right, there we go. So today we're going to be trying to cruise with our prop RPM at about 1500. That's going to be the goal for us to maximize the cruise at the altitude that we are at. And there's some tables that I'll be monitoring. So we have a very solid start on that side. So what we can do now is essentially we can, oops, not that. We want to get the right on and the right AC bus on. Now let's go ahead for that left start, take a quick left. All the throttles are where they need to be as far as the fuel and the condition lever, and it's clear. We're going to watch that prop change its pitch. There goes this changing its pitch on the blades or on the props. And now we have good rotation there. All right, go ahead and take a look and make sure she comes up nicely. Wait for this one to stable out. Let's get that prop RPM just above 900 to the 1000 range. Turbine looks good. All right. Looks like we have a good start there, so we can go ahead and get that generator on, and we can also turn on that so that we get correct readings from that. And let's go ahead and turn our auto feather on while we're thinking about it down here, as well as our pitots, because everything else is going to happen good. Let's get our stall warning going on there just in case that's going on. Let's say we want our prop heat to auto. That's all doing good there. Let's come down here. Of course, we need to mess with our rudder boost. There we go. That needs to come all the way up to that position. All right, let's look at the enunciator panel here. Left enviro external power is on. So now we can turn that off. We don't have to worry about the batteries charging. And of course, there we go. So our enunciator panel is looking really good. Let's come up and make all the recalls. Everything up top is good. Let's go ahead and pull out our oxygen. And now we can get our power on here. All of our EFIS power here for our HSI and our PFD, primary flight display. And let's move this needle for our climb out. That's pretty much usually what the rotation is. Not to mention this manual did not come with the speeds there based off the weight, just the cruise power and stuff. So, but I've flown this aircraft quite a bit. All right, on our heading, we need basically 10 on the heading. Now we can come over here to the GPS here and make sure our course direction is all situated. And it is. And then one thing you always want to pay attention to anyway is the actual flight plan to make sure the aircraft is going to do what it needs to do. This is telling us to get to the runway 31 left, and then here's the radio. So in the meantime, let's do what we said we would do. And let's get our COM2 going.
In course heading, altitude, end of flight.
Figure out what that's going to be.
Leave back all runway assignments and hold short instructions. Advise on initial contact you have information via Palm Springs International Airport, ATIS Information Sierra, 0053 symbol, wind 300 at 23, gust 31, visibility 10, sky condition, clear, temperature 30, dew point 8, altimeter 2968, arriving and departing runways 31 left, 31 right, visual approaches in use.
All right, we could pretty much shut that off, and it said it's altimeter's 2968. So let's set that here, 2968 there. Temperature was looking good, and the active runway is 31 left, which we'll be doing. So we'll be probably taxiing Whiskey Alpha. So that's all squared away. In the meantime, let's also get our flaps down. As you can see, it's now indicated and it's now set, which is good to go. And let's look at all of our ailerons and rudder tabs. They are all zeroed out. The trim right here is in a good position. Friction locks are set. And let's go up now and get our master lights on. Of course, let's dim these two. We don't need that. Just make sure we have plenty of light here. And let's also verify that our generator's got the right amount of DC power pumping out of there, which we do. All right, see, we got a little bit of illumination here, which is not half bad. Now we need to turn our transponder on, of course. We set it to 5612. Now we're going to turn it all the way on. All right, transponder is all the way on. And now what we need to do, folks, is once we start pulling out of here, I'll get the fuel mixture all the way up and we'll turn the props up for a nice little smooth taxi. So without further ado, let's come over here and plug in our, this is our ground, and let me take a look here and see what our tower is. The tower frequency is 19.7. So let's go ahead and get that in there. 19.7. And let's go to our secondary frequency now, our departure, just on, to be on the safe side. Let's see. Okay. Got to remember how to switch this over here. This thing on different ones acts differently, so let's see if it wants to do this one. Here we go. So we switched it over just by pushing that. Now it's 1267, so if we want to switch everything over here, once we talk to air traffic control, we just need to switch the mic over to COM2 and then hit that. But I'm going to probably put 1267 here before we depart. So right now, everything's looking good. We are basically almost facing the direction of the runway, of course. And we'll make sure this all matches up. This aircraft before had a problem of slaving its gyro slaving to it, but I think they've since then fixed it, so we're good to go. Now, of course, we're going to climb and maintain 7,000. So let's put that in, so when we engage the autopilot, we're good to go. And let's make sure both of our inverters are on, which they are, because that was a problem before. And we'll just do the altitude select, and sometimes it'll let you, there we go. But we'll do the nav altitude select once we get on course, and hit autopilot, because this is a very funky departure. We hit PSP twice, which is funny, so. Palm Springs ground, November 350 Kilo Tango over here at Signature FBO and Information Sierra is ready to taxi.
November 350 Kilo Tango, Palm Springs ground, turn right 3 left, taxi to Whiskey Alpha.
3-1 left, Whiskey Alpha, November 350 Kilo Tango. Alright, so we've got Whiskey Alpha in the house, so let's go ahead and recognition lights are on, flood is on, of course. Let's go ahead and hit the taxi light on, and strobe and beacon will take care of later. And let's get out of here. Now, I just want to put a little disclaimer out there. I'm still warming up and getting ultimately used to my new flight controls that I got, the Logitech flight yoke system, a few other different controls that I'm using in conjunction with it. So, yeah, I think we're ready to go here. I feel like I'm a little off kilter here. Let's see if we can do a little adjustment. There we go. Alright. Let's go ahead and release that parking brake. And we're going to bring the fuel up. And I brought the pitch of the props up as well. That's why we're moving ever so slowly here.
North Vegas Tower, Devon N 483, sir, holding short 1-2 right, go, ready to depart.
Devon N 483, Sierra, North Vegas Tower, 912 right, clear for takeoff.
Clear for takeoff, 1-2 right, 9483, Sierra.
Alright. So I have the Thrustmaster foot pedals, and what I notice, if you don't want them to react too sensitively before every flight, you must recenter them, recalibrate them before each flight, which I've been finding it's working. Found out the hard way what to do and what not to do. Alright, let's see the best way here to get to Whiskey. It's probably this Whiskey 3, which is literally right in front of us. Whiskey here. Slow down a little bit on that turn. All right, we are on Whiskey. We're going to take this full length. All right, now I'm just looking at the information down there, and it looks pretty good as far as my HSI reporting it right.
3335, I'm at the Airworks ramp. I'm requesting a progressive taxi for Eastern departure.
So we'll probably start out with an IS climb.
5,500.
All right, everything else is set up here. We're looking good. We're on GPS.
North Las Vegas ground. All right, if
you're going through the Bravo, you're headed to. Going on a Hoover Dam tour. Okay, what's your destination? Is what I'm more asking you. I will be coming back to KVTT. Flight time today is about 45 minutes or so. Hopefully, it all goes smoothly. Cruising altitude is 12,000. Initial 7,000. Slower down a little bit here on this taxiway.
172. We'll be cruising at 5,500 going eastbound. 7335. Can you also confirm the frequency as 133.9 or 5?
That's correct, 133.9 or 5 and squawk 4375.
All right, we'll come to a hold here, just slowing it down just a little bit. The more pitch those props have, the deeper they cut into that air. This thing was taxiing pretty smooth. All right, let's go ahead and set that parking brake. Shouldn't be moving. And let's go ahead and switch our frequencies over, of course. All right, folks, we're going to go 19.7 to the tower, and then we said the departure frequency is 1267. 2.6 and down to 7. There we go for the switchover. And we're going to leave it on this page, even though I typically like to follow it on the flight page. Well, if we get it direct, we'll just flip it back over. So, like I said, this is a very peculiar departure that we have. We'll make a left, head this way, and we do a whole bunch of hitting the Palm Springs radio. So, that's just kind of the way this thing goes. Palm Springs Tower, November 350 Kilo Tango on Alpha, holding short 31 left, ready for departure.
November 350 Kilo Tango, Palm Springs Tower, runway 31 left, clear for takeoff.
31 left, clear for takeoff, November 350 Kilo Tango. Alright, so we've been cleared. So up we go. On to the strobe. Alright. And parking brake is released. Let's just check a look at final, make sure there's no inbound. Runway is clear. Got our condition levers to full. Everything is looking good. Let's go ahead and get that power going. Gotta watch the prop. It's right at the borderline of red. Airspeed is alive.
North Las Vegas ground 73335. How do you hear?
November 73335, Las Vegas ground loud and clear.
Sorry, my bad, I got disconnected somehow.
Okay, so just
all right, engines look good. And rotate.
3.95 and your squawk 4375.
Copy 73335.
Goddamn Brazon.
Heavy departure frequency of 133.95. Squawk frequency of 4375. This should be showing up.
Number 335, read back, correct. Runway
1-2-8,
taxi via...
Pitch up there.
Alpha, call. Crossway 7 at call.
Then we'll do idle, pilot on. IAS.
I've got a departure of 1-2-8, via Bravo, Alpha, Golf, cross 7 at Golf.
All right, so there we are to hit the radial to make the right turn, so the aircraft is doing what it's supposed to do. And we're going to go flaps up.
Tango, contact departure.
Over to departure, November 35, Zero Kilo Tango.
November 335, line the field that you parked.
73225.
Alright, let's make sure we got the right one. 1267. So, got departure number 350 Kilo Tango is 1900, climbing 7000.
0350 Kilo Tango, so got departure with a contact, climb and maintain 12000.
Up to 12000, November 350 Kilo Tango. Alright, so we're going to go up to 12000 and we're going to go into a vertical speed climb here in a second. Let's hone in on this here. Hi, plane is bouncing around. It's the only thing about this track IR. but can't live without it. Every now and then it messes up and I'm forced to. Alright, airspeed is holding here, about 130 knots, but we're going to be changing that here in a second. So we're good there. So we're about 1500 feet per minute. So what I'm going to do now is just go ahead and put it into the vertical speed mode. And let's go up. Let's see.
94-83, sir. That's 1-3-7-8,000, please.
Okay, vertical speed still. For whatever reason, it was nose down. Alright, now we should be, no matter what, nosing up. And, or pitching up, I should say. So it's right about, you know, we still got a ways to go. It looks like it's right at about 7,000, so. Or 700 feet per minute.
Right, 1-3-13,000?
Alright. Now we're going to go ahead and pull that props back slightly. There we go. And we need to really look at these. Now we can maximize a little bit more turbine for the climb. All right, you can see the aircraft is doing what it needs to do to get itself on course. And all of the engine gazes look pretty good. Torque is in the yellow. Because on this simulation, the aircraft engines will catch on fire. It's done that plenty of time. That's why I love this. All right, you can see we are at 1,700 feet per minute on the autopilot. And we're keeping a nice climb speed. All right, let's do our checks here. Gears up, of course. Flaps are up and clean. Look at the flap gauge there. Let's go ahead and turn off our recognition lights on the taxi.
Fox, over to 134.2.
All right, so she's continuing to climb. Let's get a little flyby here.
5942 Fox, expect the analyst for 16 approach the Van Nuys altimeter.
All right. Let's go back in the cabin really quick and just take a look and see what passengers see. Nice little departure there from the Palm Springs area in a turboprop. Alright, not much to look at back here. Got a nice climb here. Let's go ahead and take a look at our GPS. Well, essentially this departure is really funky. You take off, you get on the radio, you hit Palm Springs. We're going to go to Elmrud, Cud, and then we come back to Palm Springs and depart out of this valley. And that's just to ensure you have enough altitude to clear the mountains. So we'll end up passing right over Palm Springs at a different altitude. Alright, let's go ahead and look at our fuel stores here. Right now that's on the Ox, put it on the main. You can see we've got about 2,000 pounds of fuel. And we are most certainly looking good here.
Liberty Charlie Charlie, can I go come approach 128.1.
Now we can get our prop sync on.
So CalProach Skyline 3025 Foxtrot is level with F500.
And we get our auto feather off.
3025,
once we get a lot higher, we'll get our RPMs to where we're cruising at 1500 RPMs. So we're still keeping a good climb speed. So we'll leave it right here. Look at that view. That's what makes it all worth it. So we're essentially going to make a teardrop turn here.
Contact the approach at 124.55, that's 991, thank you.
See those props working hard.
Approach Bear 1, Palm Springs, 91 Juliet, is with descending 6,800 to 5,500.
Talking over each other here.
Number 0, Kilo 7 left, direct to Palm Springs via wall, resume on navigation.
Resume on navigation, and back on course for number 35 Zirkel Tango.
Now 1697 Juliet. Edis, first of all, Las Vegas Phillips, Edis, Quebec is current. Advise when you have Quebec, up to 2970.
2972, we'll go
for a quick. So, Imrod, he's saying resume on navigation, but that's what it's going to do anyway. It's going to turn right back around and be on navigation. And you can see here we're almost at our cruising altitude.
Thanks for that, man.
So we've pretty much reached our cruising altitude still on our departure. So this aircraft now is going to turn itself around. So we're going to start a nice right turn, if you will. And we're going to be picking up speed and then we'll adjust it.
Yeah, 97 Juliet, we're going to keep going down to 4,000.
All right. So now we're going back on course. And it's picking up. So let's get our props down here to about 1500, which means we can also pick up on speed. Right there, and I'll pull up now the power, and we can utilize some more of that torque and turbine to maintain and our speed, our cruise. So that's looking good. We'll look at some of the prescribed power settings for it. Essentially, what you want to do is have your pop at about 1500 RPM on cruise. You can see we're still picking up speed even in the turn, even though there's more resistance.
Joshua, approach Mojave at 729079.
All right, so as you can see, we made that turn. Now we're headed directly back to the PSP VOR. And there's Palm Springs itself, so now it'll be off of our left wing, essentially. And we will be departing this valley. We have our yaw damper on, our autopilot, nav, and altitude established. All right. So we are at 12,000 out of the. And our cruise is turning our landing off. We'll keep peeking in strobe on. Everything else is looking good. All the power is where it should be. And now we'll just listen to our air traffic control. Let's go here. Let me bring this little sight down just a little bit. There we are.
7948
was that Palm Springs Airport down there where we departed. All right, right at 12,000, and that speed is looking good. See our speed right there.
Departure 7335 at 3,000, requesting Bravo clearance.
All right, now we're going to be making our left direct D-way, of course.
7335, Las Vegas departure, ready to contact. What is your intentions once in the battle?
Transversing over to the Hoover Dam, and I'll request clearance back once I get to that point. But for now, just heading over to the Hoover Dam eastbound at 5,500.
7335, what you on?
All right, folks, so we are just literally going to cruise here at 12,000, monitor the aircraft and ATC. We'll be getting some frequencies programmed here in a second. And that way we can get ready for the ILS approach, if that's what we're taking in Oxnard, as well as what the tower frequency is, and just have that on standby. And of course, we can also get some music rolling.
Can you give me a vector?
Number 235, it'll be approximately a heading, suggested heading of 150. Once you get up a little higher, it can give you a definitive heading.
Thank you. 7-3-2-5.
All right. Might need to turn the volumes up just a little bit.
Let me try to fly heading 200-200. 200, let me try to try.
All right, hopefully that's loud enough and not too loud. And we are cruising. If you can see, our speed is right under the barber's pole.
7-3-2-5.
Aircraft is doing good.
Thank you.
There's nothing out of whack. Let's go ahead and check on our GPS here. This is about a 35 nautical mile range. We'll do it up to about 50. And I could declutter some of that, but I think it'll be fine. All right, we'll start getting our localizer information program here in a second. Let's just enjoy some of this view as we depart this Palm Springs Valley into the open.
All right. On flight following. Okay, I mean, I can help you, but if you want to just do that for the sake, that's fine. But so certainly it's going to be fine. Change to advisory if you can move.
Is the
Las Vegas departure, Walker,
frequency. So it's right here, 108.7. It's probably in there from a while when I flew this route. So all we got to do is switch that over, and the approach course, of course, is 256. Let me see if I need to program this into this as well. Nav 2, 108.7. Let's just put it on the Nav 2 side as well. 108.7. Invalid entry. Oh, that's why. 108.7. Oh, it doesn't let you put a decimal there. Let's see if it. There we go. Huh, that was strange.
Contact Bobby Tower at 1.
Alright, still on course there. Speed's looking good. Torque is still in the yellow, but not in the red, so we'll take it. SoCal approach, 125.4, 435 circular tingle. Alright, 125.4.
270, intercept the localizer. I'm going to try and try.
SoCal approach, November 35, 0 kilo tango, 12,000. SoCal approach, November 35, 0 kilo tango, 12,000. Maybe that wasn't the right frequency. It said 125.4. SoCal approach to 4350 kilo tango. Frequency we got was 125.4. That's probably it. Maybe it's the internet. Let me take a look, see here.
2350,
Ontario, altimeter 2990. And that frequency was 125.4, correct?
1354.
Okay, you got cut off again, sir. Was that 135.4?
One 135.4.
Okay, thank you, sir. Something must be going on with the internet. Thanks a lot. Number 135, Circle Tango. Alright. Alright, so it's 135.4. There we go.
Walker 446, we have flight frequency 133.2.
Alright, there's some dinging in the background when he's talking, so. Anyways, no worries there. We got that figured out. That beautiful scenery out there. Good day for flying. Alright. So you can see we're not yet quite halfway there. In the flight information above, you can see the altitude is pretty much reporting what it should be.
5-2 Foxtrot, turn right, heading 1-0.
Boy, that beeping in the background is loud. It's probably not going to be as loud as for you guys, because I got it turned down a little bit.
Four two five, 7 3 7 Whiskey Alpha is at 2,700 and climbing. 7 3 7 Whiskey Alpha, SoCal, approach, ready to contact.
Whiskey Alpha, proceed on course. Remain outside of our airspace.
Proceed on course. Remain outside of our airspace. 737 Whiskey Alpha.
All right, we're just cruising along here.
Let's
check our flight plan out here, see what we're looking at. Pretty soon we'll be direct Van Nuys, and once we get to that leg, it'll be 36 nautical miles, so we'll start thinking about the ATIS. See what the ATIS is over there. 1805 is the ATIS, and it'll be Point Magoo Approach that we'll be contacting. So let's just program in 1805. Actually, let's come down here and do that. All right. 188. Oops. 18.05. Switch that over, and then of course the tower frequency at Oxnard is 3495. 1-3-4-9-5-0. All right, so we got the tower in there, so you want to stay ahead of the aircraft. Now we should definitely come over here and see if we can even get the ATIS.
All runway assignments and hold short instructions. Advise on initial contact to have information X-ray.
So X-ray's current.
Oxnard Airport, 8 with information X-ray. 0151 Zulu. Wing 270 at 12. Delivery 10. View clouds at 2,500. Ceiling 3,500 broken. 4,800 overcast. Temperature 17. 2.12. Altimeter 2,900. 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 back all on the radio assignments on hold short instructions. Advise on initial contact.
There we go. So it sounded like it was 299 or 2 information X-ray. So we'll keep that information for now. We have X-ray on board. X-ray may change just depending on the time. And still pretty early. It's not even half the hour yet, so we may remain X-ray, to be honest with you. So, no worries there. Let's go ahead and get some information at Oxnard 2 just to bounce it off of the ATIS that we heard. I'm also in flight aware right now. I'm going to go ahead and check the weather there to make sure the altimeter and that information match it up. Altimeter there is 299.2, which is correct. The wind is 12 knots out of the west at 280. And we've got few clouds at 2,500, broken at 35, and overcast at 4,800, 10 miles of visibility. So yeah, that should work out fine for us. So the runway we're coming on, it's only one stripper runway. It's runway 25, and whatever that opposing number is, 180 degrees off. And the ramp is to the left, and then from there we'll get a car and go to our pickup site in Oxnard for our truck, and then figure out where we're what we're taking. In what truck and where it's being dropped off. In the meantime, here we are just cruising right at 12. Oh, one of the markers must be picking up on the nav frequencies. See that? Oh, it's over now. But our speed is remaining constant. And yeah, we're cooking with Crisco. We're almost on the direct leg towards Van Nuys. There we go. Fix ourselves for 299 or 2. Altimeter. I cannot recall if he updated us on the altimeter, but we're going to put it there. And it was only a difference of 100 feet or so. So that's really not a big difference as far as the radar is concerned. Still 12,000. Once we get our next radio transmission, look at that. Speed is up slightly, so let's pull that power back just ever so slightly there. So we don't want to overspeed the aircraft. And that's what I say, even with this aircraft, when you get comfortable that it's cruising, even though there's no auto throttles, you still got to watch it because the winds change and variables change. So you got to go ahead and make sure that you're monitoring that. Because like I said, in this aircraft, on several occasions, especially when I first got it years ago, I did overheat the engines. It is all modeled, so they did a great job with the realism on this particular Carinetto aircraft. Some of them are more detailed and modeled than others, but this one does well. The realism, so you better make sure you're doing what's necessary. See, I believe at Van Nuys they're going to want us at 4,700 feet. Don't give me the line, but I know it's not 12,000 feet, so I'm just going to get this ready lower than what it is so that we can at least start some type of descent immediately once he says. So we bring that power back.
Welcome to 46, descending of the Jetty 5 arrival.
We'll keep it at 5,000 there for now.
Southwest 2211, 3.3, climbing on the radar 1.
Southwest 2211,
Las Vegas departure, with a contact time 18 photo with 190.
Up to 190 Southwest 2211.
7592 Foxtrot, contact that ice tower 119.3.
42 Foxtrot over the tower.
So, where there's a little bit of precipitation here, so what we want to do is let's get that to normal. Let's get that to normal. And there we go. So we got our oxygen pulled out. We're only at 12,000 feet, so we wouldn't have got hypoxia anyway. Auto feather is off. Prop sync is on. Turn the prop sync on and get the auto feather back on. Once we get closer.
25, you're the Bravo, where you left your Bravo airspace. Remain outside Bravo airspace at all times.
7335, we'll remain out of the Bravo. Thank you.
I was hoping he gives us a little shortcut. Van Nuys, which is pretty much a direct western heading, just give us that, straight that over straight to Kudak. As you can see, which has you going south just a little bit, then back north or back west towards runway 25, and you can see it's 258, so that's pretty much lined up directly. But if we have to go to Fillmore, it's no worries there, because then we can just do our Fillmore direct, as you see there.
KN350 SoCal
Tango,
approach
134.2. SoCal approach 34.2, number 35 SoCal Tango. Alright, so 34.2.
Whiskey
Alpha, contact SoCal approach 135.4. 135.4,
SoCal
Yellow.
Southwest 2211, contact North Central, center 1-3-3.2.
33-3, Southwest
2211.
SoCal approach,
to number
35, SoCal Tango, 12,000.
KN350,
SoCal approach, perfect Alpha, 292. 292, number 35, SoCal Tango. And see, we already had it in there, so we're good to go. No descent instructions yet, but we're still cumulatively 58.3 nautical miles out of there. You know, I like the information that this older Garmin GNS 530 gives us. Even though it's a little primitive, it doesn't do airways and things like that, but it does give you like cumulative information, so this is pretty intuitive. Also, too, let's say we wanted to do a VNAV. You can set it all up right here, which is pretty nice. So let's just say we wanted to be at 4,700 feet at the... Well, let's see. Let me just double check here and see where we should be. At Fillmore, even. Okay, so at Kudak, we're supposed to be at 4,200 feet. Fillmore, there really is no information regarding that point, so let's just say that we were trying to plan for Kudak at 4,200 feet. Well, this thing is pretty slick, so you just come in here, you're going to tap this on, and we're going to say we want 4,200 feet, right? Hang on, let me change that. This is some, like, motivational song. Not that we don't want motivation, just not this one. At any rate, so we're going to program in 4,200 feet right here. It's going to be MSL, which is sea level, and then we want it to happen right at it, so 0 nautical miles before, which means basically at it, and then we're just going to choose. So it won't choose Kudak right now because we haven't activated the approach. Then it'll allow us to do it. So let's just say at Fillmore that we wanted to be all...
I thought they canceled the clearance. Let me remain on
the... We'll say Fillmore. Let's say we wanted to be at Fillmore at, you know...
Approach for North Las Vegas Tower at 119.
Say 6,000 feet. Now we say we're one of the 18... Well, let's say actually that we want a 1,500 feet per minute descent, and you can see right here we would start our descent in 2 minutes and 28 seconds, and when this gets to actually 1 minute even and it gets to 59 seconds, it'll say begin descent. And this is actually where if we were to begin descent right now, we would only have to pitch for negative 960 vertical speed. Anyway, that's how that works, in case you didn't know. So this, even though, like I said, you have to do a lot of manual operating of this aircraft, there is a lot of information that you can gather from that GPS to make you have a successful flight.
Roger, Foxtrot, missed approach as published, and then I'd like the radar vectors for the LDA Charlie next.
That's 2.25 right hand, radar cockpit. 350 Kilo Tango, do you set to maintain 7,000? Approach request, please, for excellent.
Hey, down to 7,000, and we can do the ILS 25, and we do have information X-ray, November 35, sir. Tango.
350 Kilo, Roger, expect the ILS 25 approach.
Expect the ILS 25 approach, November 35, sir. Tango. All right.
Correct.
Okay, so he said 7,000. Let's pull the power back. That way we can go ahead and start our descent.
November 37, Whiskey Alpha, US Sierra, Fair Bracket Field.
So I'm tapping this. And he's probably going to have us contacting Point McGrew approach. And it might help. Altitude select verse. I didn't even have it selected. Alright.
4,500 straight to KVGT.
Alright. So now we've started that descent. As you can see, it's going down now, and of course we can stop the music.
Keep taking me over. 5,500.
All right, music is stopped.
Fly heading 230, cleared into the Las Vegas airspace.
Now you can see here we're pitching down about negative 1,500 feet per minute. Let's go ahead and arm the lights because we're going to be passing below 10,000.
And episode 235 cleared into Bravo.
Let's get a pitch down of 300 more feet.
235 is cleared into Bravo airspace. Thank you.
All right. So now we're at 1,800 feet pitch down.
225, when you want those vectors, let me know.
425 will do.
Now here's what we're looking at. So here's Fillmore. Technically, we're supposed to go direct, but he's saying that we are going to expect that. So, in the meantime, our best plan of action would be to square up the heading.
Number 350 Kilo Tango, heading 260. That's the vector for the final approach course. Set to maintain 5,000.
260 down to 5,000. November 350 Kilo Tango. All right, that's funny. We were just talking about that. So now we're going to go ahead and select aircraft on heading, follow heading of 260, and now it's down to 5,000, which is copacetic for us. And we're going to get what we want. Now we're going to take this and put this on the VLOC. Because we most certainly have our 108.7 frequency in there. Now let's go ahead and pull that speed back.
Copy.
Power's coming way back. Alright, down we go, down to 5,000. Kudak is supposed to be at 4,200, so I'm assuming he's going to want us to get down further than that. So probably he's probably got us right at Van Nuys, even though we don't have a program in here. And then we're going to go to Kudak. Wait, McGrew approach 124.7 and 230 on the heading, number 35, Circle Tango. Alright, so 230 on the heading and 124. Let's do it this way. It's getting busy, guys. Alright, 124. decimal 7. Wimigo approach number 350 Kilo Tango is 6,900, descending 5,000, information X-ray at the field.
Okay, 350 Tango, Wimigo approach, descend to maintain 4,000, altimeter 2992.
2992 down to 4,000, over 350 Kilo Tango. Alright guys, it's getting hairy here. Let's go to 4,000.
That's what happened. 45 Sierra Papa, runway 2,300.
Let's get a little more aggressive on the pitch.
Climb maintain 7,000. 435 Sierra Papa.
And you can see we're passing right through there. And then we also want to take note that the tower frequency there is 3495.
That's Golf Victor Oscar.
All right, so 3495.
All right. 8 miles from Hoopla. Flight Pro with Eddie, descend to 4,000 for establish on a localizer, cleared ILS 25 approach.
Okay, down to 4,000, we'll maintain present heading until establishing a localizer for ILS 25 approach, November 350 Kilo Tango. Alright, so now we have our approach activated. You can see the localizer and all that good stuff. It wants us to fly present heading down to 4,000 until established on the approach. This should start coming over. As you can see, we're going to capture the localizer. It's off to our left right now. Once we capture it, this will go straight. This little line will come over straight. This will line up straight, and we're also going to catch the glide slope. And what I tell you, he's going to have us lower than we needed to, because at Kudak we were supposed to be at 4,200. So now let's let the aircraft bleed some speed so we can start throwing them some flaps. All right, let's go up top and look. Let's go ahead and get our auto feather on. Pop sync off.
The departure frequency is 127.4.
First stage of flaps
Rock
coming down.
637, hold for release.
All right. You can see here, this is where the we're about to capture the localizer. We're going to keep the aircraft about 120 knots for now. So we're throwing some more power. Now you can see the localizer is captured and we're making a nice right turn. Line us up straight with the runway. We're going to stay at 4,000. The glide slope will become active here. We're just past Kudak in between Hoopla. It should go active. All right. Throwing some more power. And of course, we're putting the condition levers all the way to full so you can hear those pumping up. Almost we're at right at here at stall speed, but we have to pick it up a little bit because we got that resistance on. Once the glide slope comes down, we'll go ahead and at this dot here put our landing gear down. And again, 134.905. And the ground there is Oxnard Tower, 3495. We'll see a King Air 35s or Kilo Tango.
Walk 446 heavy.
Oxnard Tower, number 350 Kilo Tango, ILS 25.
Number 350 Kilo Tango.
All right, so the field is right there. We're just above the cloud cover. We got ourselves about 120 knots. We have these throttles pushed all the way up. The fuel is all the way up. And now that is down, so let's go ahead and drop our landing gear. Landing gear handle is coming down. And another stage of flaps, of course. It's going to cause us to throw in just a little bit more power. And the runway is about 5,000 feet. We're going to use reversers. So we are essentially pretty much going to stay right here. As far as our flaps are concerned, there's one more stage of flaps that we could utilize that we won't. and then we'll get on the ground, taxi it in, and shut her down, and then we can do some replays, of course. Alright, if we look out there, field is in sight right here, folks. Bringing that speed back down slightly. Alright, let's verify. Gear is down. We do have our flaps set all the way down, actually, so we're doing all the way down. I thought this had three stages of flaps, so shame on me, but that's why we're checking. The auto feather's on. Now we can go ahead and turn all of these the icing surfaces off.
7172 CFM, I'm not sure where you're headed. You're supposed to be entering the right downwind runway 30. Looks like you're headed to the left.
All right, we're right at that 120 speed.
Would you like to continue the practice or restart?
I'll continue for practice.
We are absolutely doing an amazing job here, so hopefully we can get her down. We're going to touch down hopefully right around 100 knots or so. And you can see it's a very nice, easy descent of about 700 feet per minute for that 3-degree glide slope. Let's see, lights are on. All right, gear down.
Pegasus Tower, Sirius 22 Golf Tango, holding short.
See, she's rolling nice and slow there. Let's get another little pass by. She's looking proper.
Number 22 Golf Tango, Pegasus Tower, make right down on departure.
All right, she is well lit up. All right, guys, let's have some fun. We're gonna do. Let's see the easier way to do this. We're gonna do autopilot off and yaw damper off.
22
left. All right, it's our aircraft.
Roger that. Take off.
No more flight director, of course.
Clear to take off 30 right.
No more flight director, but we're still getting approach information, which is good. That's what you want. So we're still on the glide path, and I'm just hand flying it right now. Yaw damper's off, autopilot's off. I feel like my rudder pedals are a little left than they should. It's a little bit better. All right, folks, we're just gonna fly this aircraft down. Let me bring the speed down. I'm gonna manage our descent. Kind of with the speed.
Good evening, Burbank Clearance. This is Sirius Charlie Foxtrot, Alpha Tango, for VFR flight plan to the east at 3000, requesting VFR flight following.
So basically, I'm managing our pitch with speed. I'm not doing a whole lot with any of the pitch trims or anything like that. It's a little trick about these lighter aircraft. You can manage a lot of your descent with your speed because they are so light. You're not going to really get away with that on a larger aircraft, even though speed is a factor, but the weight is also a factor. All right. Just hunted a little bit of pitch.
It's for VFR departure. I filed a flight plan.
Throw some more power in there. So we can get some more lift.
I'd like to request,
there we go.
Django.
Okay. It's keeping us right on that path.
How high are you going and where I'm going?
So it's Cirrus, Charlie Foxtrot, Sierra Tango. SR 22, and it's to KFUL, and it's for 3,000 feet. Sierra Alpha Tango.
Thank you. All right, right on that glide slope, two red, two green. I'm sorry, two red, two white.
Maintain VFR at or below 2,500 Departure frequency 1.
Nice stable approach, folks.
Clock 1646.
500 call out. Slightly high, that's okay. I thought I'd like to be. I sometimes tend to be too low on these aircrafts when I approach.
2,500, 134.2, and squawk 1646, Sierra Alpha Tango.
All right, folks, let's go ahead and make this money.
9925, with you on the LVA Charlie approach.
The 714 shot, that I have power. Tackle west of the field for a right spacer and a 16 west report turning final.
To land for a right base, 16 left, 42 Fox report turning final.
Alright, landing, we didn't nose up. That's okay though. Alright.
Contact departure, 22 left angle.
We don't car.
Runway 30 clear.
All right, folks. He's right on off.
737 is clear of the active at Charlie.
It was a bit of a hard landing. You know, these.
Sierra, man, these 50. Thanks for the help. 737 with you.
North Las Vegas, 7-3-3-3-5. Number 7-3-3-5, North Las Vegas Tower.
I requesting to land. I have information, Foxtrot.
So not the best landing, but you know what? It's going to be the landing that we take.
I'm sorry.
It's still a realistic landing, just a hard landing, so shame on me, but that's okay. We had a wonderful approach. There's really no excuse pulling that power back. We just kind of slammed it hard, no worries. Bring that prop down a little bit more. And where are we on? We are, oops.
I might have to
let's go to the other side here and take a look-see. We are on, looks like Delta holding short of Foxtrot.
Descending to altitude 73225.
Oxnard Tower, number 350, kilo tango clear of 25 on Delta holding short Foxtrot.
Number 350 kilo tango taxi to park via Foxtrot on end of bank.
Okay, two Foxtrot to the ramp and monitor ground. Number 350 kilo tango.
Negative, and this frequency is 350 kilo tango.
Apologies, this frequency number 350 kilo tango. All right, so this frequency is to Foxtrot, and it will be done. It'll be time to get into some replays and then some trucking. Let's see, park and brake is going to be released. And we are going to basically taxi all the way down to almost where the terminal area is at. So guys, not the best landing, but definitely a nice stable approach. And like I said, I actually land larger aircraft better than these. These are so much lighter. We had a hard landing, but that's okay. Realistic, we didn't break the landing gear off. It was just a harder one. So now we'll taxi here nice and easy. Actually had some pretty amazing landings and practices with my new flight controls. You know, even though you know how to fly with other controls, it's always you got to get accustomed to the new ones, get your key mapping, then memorize that so that when you're flying, you know what you're touching. So.
Left, down one, 6 left.
See that windsock right there? Reflecting the wind. I believe the wind was 280 at 4 knots.
Would it be okay to make a left, down one for one?
Negative, you're circling to circle for a right base.
All right, so there's the terminal area, basically. So we're going to just start making our way over there. And just park off in the cut, if you will.
Taxi parking via Alpha, and I'll remain with you. To Sierra Papa.
River 1-3-3-3-5, we got a call on the down one.
Cutting some of that good old stuff off. that we don't need.
North Las Vegas Tower, 7-3-3-3-5.
Start bringing stuff down to low idle. It's going to park right here.
7-3-3-5, I see that. It just, you got to comply with the instructions so that I can help you get in quicker. You were told to report midfield, but now you're past the airport. Runway 12 right to clear to land.
All right.
12 right, clear to land.
Parking brake is set. And we have that stuff done. Let's go ahead and get our inverters off, our generators off, of course. And our recognition light off. We'll leave beacon. We'll take that off. We'll leave the nav on. Taxi light can come off, of course. Because we need to save battery power. So, yep, we're going to turn that off. And, yeah, we can shut her down now. Let's turn our bleeds off, too, of course. And our rudder boost. Anything that doesn't need no juice. No juice. Alright. Alright. Bring it down. Help those slow down. There we go.
42 Foxtrot. Turning final for 16.
And of course,
we
can most certainly turn this off as well. And turn them off as well. We don't need to hear them. Not to mention, we need to go ahead and disconnect from Pilot Edge so that we can get into the replays. All right. We'll probably open the door after the replay. So let's just go ahead and get into the replays and see exactly how we did. We're going to keep getting these warnings, of course. Well, we'll do the replay without external power. I don't want any problems. So let's toggle the replay mode and see exactly how we did. Let's get us ourselves a little closer. Boy, tower can pick us up. Alright, so there we are on this approach here. Let's get another little flyby view, of course. Nice and slow approach. There's the runway right in sight. So let's see what we did wrong here on this wonderful landing that we had. Again, approach was nice and stable. I managed it with the speed. A little bit of pitch adjustments, not much. All right, so here we had a nice little flare. And, you know, we just hit down hard. We kept the nose up, so it's really... The nose was still up, so it was just a hard touchdown. I probably dropped a little bit too much speed, and that was the problem. So I'm still very satisfied with that landing. Very stable approach. Very well handling of the plane. Just wasn't butter. It was just a little harder. But everything else looked good. Let's come for a different view of this, of course. It was almost on the touchdown mark, just a little past it. That nose touchdown pretty much center line. Had reversers on. All right, let's check it out. From that view, yeah, you can see it how it kind of looked touchdown pretty bad. Oh yeah, it looks good. You guys know what I like to do. Let's go back and do a little bit of a wing view. All right, now we can get ourselves a wing view in here. Left side. We'll be back here as if for a passenger. We'll keep the track IR on. We're not going to do any more replays, I don't think. Nice gray day, but still a pretty good day for flying. The winds weren't too immensely bad. Overall, it was pretty smooth. We pretty much handled the aircraft and did all the procedures that we were supposed to. Probably dropped that speed. Had I kept that speed up a little more, it would have been a better landing. I probably also could have landed on approach flaps with a little bit higher of a speed, which would have automatically made me keep the speed higher, and that's usually a more of a greaser. The full flaps landing, sometimes I tend to tank drop those, but that's okay. We still landed within normal range. Just a harder landing. Alright, so we'll just let it ride out here to a little music, and we'll get the plane doors open, of course, which you may not see, and we will get into our car and get over to our truck to pick up whatever load we're picking up to head wherever we are going to head. Thank you guys for joining me on this flight, and I look forward to seeing you on board as well in the big rig. Okay, so here we are, finally off that flight. It is the next day in the morning, 6-something in the morning. Let's get the specifics of that. Actually, it is 6:29 in the morning, and we are in Los Angeles at one of my garages in Los Angeles here in American Truck Simulator. And so the best thing for us to do yesterday was to fly into Oxnard and travel by Uber over here to our garage, because this is the closest place where we could get one of our vehicles. We are in this Peterbilt 379 here. This is truck by Pinga, and this is just standard trailer here that I designed. So with no further ado, let us go pick up our load, and let me see if I can see what it is in here. Currently we have no delivery job. I suppose we have to just simply let's see, how do I get back out of here? There we go. So we simply got to go pick this up in Oxnard, which is 54 miles from here. So let's go ahead and fire up the truck. And it's pretty early in the morning, but we'll still have some lights on just to be on the safe side. Go ahead, jump in the rig, of course. Get my seat situated here. And let's get going. As you can see there, we got a full tank of gas on the dash. So we got to get going, because we don't want to belabor this so the customer doesn't get angry. I think we're going somewhere to Hobbs, New Mexico, if I believe correctly, but I don't quite remember. So when we get to Oxnard, to the location, we will most certainly figure that piece out. Alright, let's see here. Come on, be gentle with me, guys. Alright, clear left and clear right. Good thing it's nice and bright in the morning. Nice and early, I should say. We'll get some music going on here in a minute. Alright. On our way. So I think once we get the load, it's about a day's drive. So we'll kind of monitor the time. I'll try to do most of the drive in the daytime, so that we can take care of some good scenery. All right, gonna be making a right up here, but looks like we gotta get over here for a second. We get on the highway and out of LA, we'll go ahead and put some jams on for your listening pleasure. All right, let's make sure we come to a complete stop here at the line. Wait, we don't get ding. Turns out it's green anyway. Ahead and file into the right lane until we figure out where we got to go. Let's extend that map. Okay, we're going to be apparently going straight for a while. Good thing Oxnard is not that far away, so we can get the load and still maximize some of this day here. All right, looks like we need to get over here. Left here. All right. Love driving places in here I've never been to. Looks like there's some beach activity over there. Keep it nice and easy down this hill that I've never been down. Nice and easy. Slow and steady is slew. Alright. I had to make it interesting, of course. It's close in the back. I said we should be okay, because if nice and early, I'm just going to get over until I establish that this right lane's not going to end. Alright, speed limit is 45, so keep it copacetic here. There's a guy here, don't turn right, but he's going to do it anyway. Taking in some of this early morning scenery here. And this is California, back in this residential area. So pretty sure Jake braking would not be sufficient. Even though if we have to, we will. Keep a trucker slow for now. Boy, that's some beautiful scenery. They did a great job in this simulation. Look at that. It's gorgeous. Cruising right along the coast. Step that down here. We won't need the J because I'm just going to take it easy around here. Beautiful stretch of drive though here. Alright, I'm jaking it now. And of course, we'll monitor the use of it. It's absolutely gorgeous drive here. You can hear that Jake on right there. All right. Turn it off for now. So we got some straightaways here, not a whole lot of traffic, so we should be able to just gorgeous over here. Flying into Oxnard yesterday was cloudy. Turns out it's sunny now. Alright, we'll just stay in this gear here. Gonna stay in this gear here, even though it's burning a little bit more of my gas. It's keeping me honest on the speed, because when I'm at about 1500 RPMs, it's about 45 miles per hour, so that'll work for us. Got a helicopter over there chilling. All right, looks like we got a right turn coming up, unless this is road curving, which that's what it looks like. Very interested run so far. We haven't even got the merchandise yet. Be nice to remember what we're getting once we get there. I was thinking we were going to take the highway, but guess that's what I get for thinking, right? I was in Oxnard earlier. Okay, we should be getting green arrow here. Let's see, looks like it's going to be on the right here. Brake there, it's okay. I'd rather over brake because I know about these turns here. So we can get the doggone trailer in, and they're probably more than likely going to give us the most worst parking space ever, or pickup location, I should say. All right, let's get our flashers on and let's go ahead and see what we're working with here. Let's go into this cargo market. And let's see, take job. Okay, we're doing household appliances, Hobbs, New Mexico. The run is 1,035. Trip time, 19 hours and 4 minutes. We still have 22 hours and 6 minutes for this offer to be valid. So let us go ahead and take this for now. And let's get rolling. So now we know what it is. Once again, household appliances. So it looks like, you know, some toasters and probably refrigerators, tea kettles. Cutlery, all that type of stuff. So, Oxford, California to Hobbs, New Mexico for rail export on over to Walbert. All right. So, now let's obviously assume they gave us, of course, it's probably... Oh, it's right there. Not too bad. Okay. So, we've definitely had worse. They're kind of being generous right now. All right. So, first of all, let's get the trailer in here. Take a look back there. There it is in all its glory. Let's see if our window's down. Our window already is down. Actually, drive with that window down. Okay. Check these guys out over here. Make sure we are most certainly not going to injure them. Straight approach. That's got us lined up there. Almost. Now we can pull up and straighten up. And we'll be able to have a nice good view of our target. About right there. Should be able to start straightening her up. Should give it to us here. All right. Come back and straighten her up. They always like to make it nice and close, of course. May have to bring it over one more time. See if that gives it to us. Doesn't look like it. Let's see. We should pretty much be in the lane there. A little crooked, I can see it now. Alright. Swing her over just a little bit more so she's all the way straight. And steady. Alright, we should be swinging that trailer over here now. Come on. Should give us green. There we go. Alright, but let's go out and look and see if it feels satisfactory to us. Let's get that parking brake set. Okay, so we're pretty much nice and straight in there, guys, as you see. Pretty much parallel how we wanted it. We didn't hit anything, so that's good to go. So let's go ahead and shut our lights off, and we'll go ahead and shut the engine down for now, and we will get her loaded. So we have our first spot already conquered here, so we'll go ahead and load that up. All right, we loaded that up, so let's go ahead and take a look at our map now here, and I want to double check. Okay, we got about 1,035 miles to go, 19 hours to get there, and the time now is Saturday 9:31, and they're expecting this between Monday, basically Monday by noon is our mark. So if we drive all day today, we should be able to spend the night Sunday or Saturday night, then drive all day Sunday. So we should make it there with plenty of time to have mainly daytime hours. Truck is full. So without further ado, let us get out of here. And if there's any scenic routes on the way there, then we'll try to stop and look at those sceneries. But if not, it's all about business. All right, let's get back in the rig here, guys. Let's get her fired up. We already did our walk around, so that looks good. Everything is secured. We are on our way, folks. All right, let's go ahead and pull her out of here. Of course, you know we got to swing her out. Let's swing her on out. All right, and of course, we have to go to the left. Turn our flashes off, get our signal on, and we are clear left. Let's make it happen. Whew, nice exit there. Don't mind if we do. All right, folks. See, we can pretty much run the truck with no lights right now. All right, let's get to this light. Thank you very much. Pretty sure I was supposed to stop there before I crossed the railroad tracks and put my flashers on, but I didn't do it. I don't know if that even actually applies to truckers or that's just for buses. Drove big trucks like this before, but in the military, never professionally, of course, so I don't know all of the rules. Just know how to drive them. Watch those RPMs, guys. All right, so we are rolling. Of course, it's California, so the speed limit is 55. So maybe we'll see if we can rustle up 60. Hear that turbo whistling? So hopefully we have an event-free trip here, meaning not too much traffic pulls out in front of us, as they love to, and come to brash stops in here in this simulator. Wish the AI had better behavior, but they don't. Look at this guy. Come on, man. Let me over, dude. There we go. I swear, I don't know about these trucker problems, man. Looks like it's gonna rain. Looks like some of that weather that we had yesterday landing. All right. Use a little saber gear here, and if we have to brake quickly, we'll throw on the Jake. So we are getting on the 5 South. So let's see what we have for some music here. Get some jams going on here. Because we have some rolling to do. We're going to see where we take our first rest break. Doing about 60. All right, obviously it's gonna have us doing a cut through here. Alright, let's turn this music down here. I really like to jam the music when we're on the highway, especially when I can cruise, so let's get the music down here for a second. It's funny, I've driven through all these little parts before in previous versions of this game, but driving through it again is, you know, with the better graphics and this 1.41 or whatever it is, it's pretty phenomenal to do it again. Chorus and the trucks and the sounds, everything keeps getting better. Let's just get to this little crossover town here. So essentially it had us going 5 south, but obviously we didn't need to go all the way down to San Diego, because essentially I think we're going to be taking I-40 east. So essentially we need to get up to the high desert. So this may have us cut through. I don't know where this is going to bring us out at. But we essentially need to get to the 15 north. And then on over to... of course, you know what? There is a cut through that brings us out to like Victorville. So we wouldn't even get on the 15 until Victorville. So I wonder where this is bringing us out to. Okay, we got another highway here. Let's see what we got over here. Because highways to get out of here, you would do like 5, and you have to have a highway that kind of intersects that. Like the 60. Okay, so this is the 10. And maybe we're taking the 10 into New Mexico. This says Phoenix, so this is I-10. What do we got here? 10 east. There we go. I knew it. Don't hit us. See that red car back there? Again, I like to, in this simulation, I like to get right in the middle, because sometimes the traffic will stop on the right as soon as you get on the highway. Okay, pipe it down. I believe I have Lopes. I believe this is the Marine Caterpillar. This is definitely not a Detroit Diesel. She sounds good. All right, Barstow, San Diego. So that's what we're going to get. If we're taking that route, if we're taking the 10 route, then we're just going to stay here. And it looks like that's what we're doing. You would take the other way going towards Vegas and all that good stuff. But it's got us staying left. So we're going to take this 10 instead of taking that way. That would take us up to Vegas and stuff like that. And of course, then South San Diego. So essentially, we're in a place called Ontario. That's where this interchange really happens. We'll probably see the wind fans and everything when we're passing through Palm Springs, which ironically is where we flew from on our flight yesterday. Thought we were going to pick up the load that day, but it's on the same day, but it turned out it's the next day, so whatever. We're still meeting the times for the customer. We're going slightly fast right now. Alright, so we are back on the highway. I'm gonna see if I can rustle this thing up here to at least go 5 over at 60 cruise control. There we go. Cruise is set at about 59. time check. Okay, 12:59, doing good. When we get to Arizona, so we can pick up some speed. This looks like an area, this town's called Blythe. It's basically what this looks like, so we should be hitting that Arizona border soon. Very hesitant to do that when there's so much traffic around. I've wrecked before just because the AI does weird stuff. So let's get to that border so we can kick up some speed. Of course, we'll hit the port of entry. We'll have to do a stop. So we can weigh the truck. We should be good on fuel there. This tank should be more than enough. So far we're 5 over and we haven't gotten a ticket yet, so we'll stick here. Alright, I can see here there's a situation coming up. People starting to slow down. Can't get over just yet. There's a car passing us on the right. I'll be excited when they do Texas. Almost got us. That's the type of thing I'm talking about. You got to watch out for this game, this simulation. They will get you each and every time. Okay, that guy's back behind me. Let's let him pass. This other guy's gonna let me. Okay, I think he's gonna let me get over. Thank you, sir. Guys, making some good headway. Be nice once we're out of California. Let's get a little pickup speed here. I said, hopefully once we get into Arizona, that speed can pick up a little bit. I don't remember what their speed limit is. just change that song. Suspect over here, so let's just get over. Pretty soon we're gonna hit the port of entry soon. I'll probably have to get right back over. Yep. Let me over, guy. Alright, we haven't passed anything. I'm looking at the fob at the windshield. I don't see anything, so. Alright, at least we got 65 now, but we are probably going to have to hit this weigh station up here. It's probably going to ding us red. This down. All right, here we are, gonna pass under this bar. Let's see what it gives us. Of course, red. Into the station we go. I knew it. We've been rolling with our window down anyway, so we'll get that pulled up. Maybe it'd be a little quieter in the cab. All right, let's go ahead and take care of them. We're green now. Let's get the window back up now that we've talked to them, of course. Yes, it is much quieter in here. Never fails. Can't even successfully get on the highway around here. Shame on you, Arizona. Got 75 that we can do, so let's do this. Thank you. plane right there. A little congestion happening over congestion, so I'm always watching out for that. Let's just go ahead and get over just to be on the safe side, since I know we're going to be on this for a while. And just to be a little conservative, we're not even doing the actual 75 speed limit, we're doing a little bit under 71, just because these cars will pretty much do the same correct speed that's posted, so I like to give myself a little something to play with here, if I'm being honest. All right, should probably make sure we have our lights on. There we go. Go ahead and get over. Snooze, you lose. We knew it was something. How are we doing on gas? We're doing good. All right, riding low. That's what we do. Good thing we got our lights on. Ahead and get over this, guys. I'm not trying to get as low where it needs to go. We are just cruising right here in Arizona. All right, just as soon as we decide to commit to 75, of course we're going 65 now. We are in Phoenix. And we're just gonna keep rolling. Just keep heading east. Assuming this Hobbs location, if I remember correctly, is southeast New Mexico. Just basically on the border of New Mexico and Texas. So hopefully they get Texas done soon and we'll be venturing in there and Wyoming. Tucson. I actually did this drive probably back in 1999 when I was stationed in Fort Irwin, California. I went with a good friend of mine to we weren't supposed to take that, we're good, to Corpus Christi, Texas. So we did this whole drive. It was a 21-hour drive, I believe, all together in a Mustang with a 3-year-old. Unexpected. we won't even try to get over yet. It's a little traffic here. Get over here, get off of that sidewall. Turn that music down until we get out of this Phoenix / Tucson chaos. If I remember correctly, Tucson's about an hour east of Phoenix, something like that. It's not too far in between, I think it's about an hour. Got a military base out there too, Fort Huachuca, Arizona. So we'll see how far we can get before we sleep. So far we have definitely maximized the light here. We should be able to get this thing there on time. Gotta make sure his behavior wasn't too erratic. Alright, we can kind of pick our speed back up. Jake, get around this corner so we don't have to slam on our brakes. We shouldn't really need the Jake here too much. There's no big mountains. We're not in a traffic area on a busy highway or anything like that. No little tight back roads. Pretty sure we're going to lose a lane here soon, that right lane. But it is getting dark. Must be pushing, I'm going to say, 6, 7 o'clock now. I'll have to check the time. Always a risk when you do that, but if we didn't do it, why would we even be playing this or doing this simulation? Can't do that in real life, so you might as well do it here, right? That's what I'm talking about. So we are cruising 74 miles per hour. Now you can't see it on the dash there, but I also have it digital as well as analog and the gauges. Quarters of a tank, so we burned about a quarter of a tank already. Again, even this, sometimes I don't like pushing these speeds, because in this simulation the things come up really quick, especially the dumb traffic. Like sometimes these guys get over at the last second. Hopefully he doesn't. Alright, it's time to kind of pipe it down. Anybody, let's Jake us down. We just jaked ourselves down instead of pushing on any brakes. So we can continue our journey without a ticket. El Paso, 10 East. Still doing great on gas. Play there. Let's get on this dash. Let's see. 729 is, or 730 is the time. Something like 731. So maybe we'll drive to like 10 or so, then nap. That way we can do our delivery with daylight, which is always preferable. All right, yep, so it's 7:39. We got fuel. Man, this thing's a monster on fuel. We got another 1,598 miles on fuel. We really haven't burnt anything on this thing. We got the extra fuel stores on this. Oil temp, water temp's looking good. All right. We don't have crew set right now. We're just using the gas pedal. That beautiful sky. As we travel into the night, folks, switch our display there. I don't know how far off the beaten path this location is from the 10, so I don't know if we'll be on any back roads anytime soon once we cross over into New Mexico. Pero vamos a ver qué nos pasa, ¿verdad? Seguimos manejando. If I needed to bed down now, there'd be a spot there. We'll see where we find it. I'm sorry, guy. I was going to get over for you, but that's usually not realistic in these anyway, but if you can do it, do it. But if not, not. As long as it's not too drastic. Generally, though, these trucks are designed, they either plan for people to yield on, accelerate, but can't do what four-wheelers can do. In other words, regular vehicles with just two axles. Into the night we go, folks. Enjoy the music. All right, we get to pass the way station there, which is good. But as you can see, we got somebody over here always keeping it interesting for us. Let's go ahead and get over here. All right, let's also see what time it is. It's about 9:56, so now we can start looking for a place to sleep. Behind us, let's go ahead and give them the courtesy. Get on over here and we'll get behind this rowdy bunch. We've actually made really good time. Traffic thus far has been very feasible. So hopefully we find us a nice little rest stop so we can finish the run in the daytime. We'll get some rest. And use Sunday and get there on Sunday versus Monday. This job is due Monday by 1 something, even though we gave ourselves a deadline of noon. Okay, looks like we got some services hopefully up here soon. We can just get off over here. Let's see, looks like there is a place to sleep and fuel. So this is where we are going to sleep for the night. Jake it a little bit. Boy, it's dark back here. We could pull right in that lot there. But being professionals, we're gonna get some gas first. Park off in this back a lot. Folks, doesn't make any sense to stop and not get gas, so all right folks, let's go ahead and put her in neutral and get those lights off and let's get some gas going here. All right, not looking too bad. Let's go ahead and jump back on board, break her up. Let's go find somewhere to go to sleep, because we are tired. See if we can't loop around here somewhere. should be able to get some rest here. Park and brake is set. Lights are off. And let us get some music. To the back we go. Oh, what do you know? Next day we wake up and it is raining. Would you look at that? At least we gassed up. We can just eat a little snack in the truck now. We can get rolling. Just do our morning walk around, of course. Make sure nothing's been tampered with. Load is still secure in there. And we can get going. Let's go ahead and get on the cab. Alright, let's see. It's Sunday, 8:53. We'll get our mileage. Of course, we gotta go lights on in this madness. And let's get our wipers on, of course. And let's make it happen, guys. Well, we're going to finish the run in the daytime, but it looks like it's going to be nasty bit of weather. Okay, let's figure out the road here. Let's up our wipers usage. Kind of dangerous. It's been quite the interesting journey thus far. Can't complain. Back on course. Looks like the rain is going to stop down there. They always try to get you, I tell you. Wipers off. A little summer wake up rain. Okay, guys, we are going to essentially see here how much more longer we have to go. 277 miles, so we're not doing bad at all. Gonna make it in nice and early today. Got another 5 hours to drive, so should have us there 9, 10, 11, 12, went to about 3:30 for a daytime trailer drop off and a completion to this X-Plane meets American Truck Simulator situation. Definitely been enjoyable driving highway instead of all those back roads for once. Even though the tires on this need to be replaced maybe in the next 2-3 trips, tires appreciated as well, less wear and tear. No surprises, this little stuff's going on. Yep, and so we will be there shortly, folks. As far as the simulation time, now that's the one thing this differs from X-Plane or Microsoft Flight Simulator P3D version 4. Those are real simulation hours. These are, you know, obviously condensed hours. But as you see, you know, 1,000 miles, you're still going to do a lot of driving here. You know, and if that 1,000 miles, if you're on secondary roads, you know, in the mountains, that makes it a whole lot different. So, yeah. Anyway, not much longer to cruise. I'm gonna watch my speed here. I was kind of booking, like, wait, why is everybody going slower? One of these things is not like the other, so that was us. Let's go ahead and be respectful here. Signs for Albuquerque. That 25 north, that'll take you up to Albuquerque. On into Colorado, or Pueblo, Colorado, Colorado Springs, all the way up to Denver, actually. Been on that 25 quite a bit in this lifetime. All right. It's kind of obvious we got to get off here because there's no Texas, so we're having to take a different route, head north now. Because east is done, we're pretty much on the border of New Mexico and Texas. But imagine when they get Texas done, there's going to be a lot of places to travel in that state. So I'm excited for them to get that. Honestly, I think they're doing an amazing job. These DLCs. Only getting better. Communities hopefully growing more and more. And that's for simulation and American Truck Simulator, Euro Truck Simulator, of course. Flight simulation, all platforms. Ooh, it turned out to be a nice sunny day. Might not have to get the truck washed after all. Let's not get too cocky with the drive-bys. Done well thus far. I think we got some classy music to bring us in. Let's see what we got here, guys. Thank you. All right, so we're in a little bit of a traffic situation now. Still believe we don't have much longer to go. See if we can catch this light. Absolutely not. No big deal. Of that, I skipped a couple of gears the other way, messing around the outside, so sorry about that, but you know, gotta get those outside views too. It's a gorgeous day. Hopefully we don't have any crazy turns back here. I'm just glad we didn't have to go through this, and this is not the city. I believe we're going to Hobbs, so this is literally just a pass-through. Just never drove here during this rendition of the game. Look at this guy. Let's see what we have for mileage here. Okay, we still got a little ways. 178 miles, 3 hours to go. Us getting there at Sunday at 3:10 p.m. which is a few hours from now, so we got some back roads to go probably here. I love the traffic. Folks, get that window down. Such a nice day. All right, let's turn the music up and bump in a little bit longer, guys. window back up. Jake, break it through here. Figured with that mileage, we'd have to do a few more back roads driving here because it was just too good to be true to be right off the highway, of course. It's all right, though. Yeah, that Jake is really nice around these roads like this because you don't have to rely on your brakes all the way. Got the man right in front of us. That trucker's making sure he's following the rules. Nice little drop off over there. Have done some distance. Turn the Jake off for right now. I don't see any curves. Keep our distance, watch our gears. Get our headlights on here. Oh, they were on. Okay, good for us. Oh, that's right, it was raining. Thought they were off. No Jake needed now. We're just letting the gears hold us. Place it's off in the cut. It's actually my first time making a delivery to Hobbs. Thank you. Popo turn. Not that I was going to speed anyway. Law-abiding citizen here, nothing but respect. Getting close. Turn this music down. We gotta be getting somewhat close. Put that window down. Still got some cooking to do here. Looks like we made the light. Yes! Only to be back at 25 miles per hour again. It's okay. Let's get back in our appropriate trucker lane here, so we're abiding by best practices. speed limit's 40. Get that window back up. And apparently we can put some tunes back up. Miles, folks. So we are almost there. All right. So we can get the jams all the way down. Let's get that window down. Right on time, 3-3 something. There's Hobbs, that's where we wanted to be. Let me see, looks like I'm going straight in. I don't know if I'm making a right or a left. We'll just get back to this. So this is Hobbs, in all its glory. Looks like we're going to be going to the right. Drop this load off. And then we will call it, I would say day, but it's been more like 2 days. All right, we're coming up here on it shortly. Okay, I see the Walbert. All right, now we got a truck. We're probably going to have to swing wide here, so let's let him go. not hate where they have the trailer. Let's go ahead and okay, so backing in here, so we're gonna come around and pull it in this way. So we'll go around the building. All right, guys, let's get our flashers on. I know we're blocking traffic. All right, guys, so welcome to Hobbs, New Mexico. It's way out here. I didn't realize it was this far out, of course, but nobody pays me to know this stuff. It's a big building. That's a lot of real estate they have here in this building. Or if this is like a warehouse. Or just a really big Walmart slash Burt. Let's go ahead and get out and take a look here really quick. Put that parking brake on. Looks like our tire's almost about to hit that, but not. Okay, so we can just pull up a little bit straight, and then we're almost in there, guys. It's just those blind turns that are always a miracle. Straighten it up and then soften that turn. So we can come up slightly. Ever so slightly. Right there is what I'm comfortable with. I don't know if we're gonna clear that trailer over there. We might have to just pull back up again. Work. If not, we'll have to pull up more. If we don't make that trailer. Okay, I don't think we will. This is ugly. All right. Almost had her. All obviously going to be too close to that doggone wall. Yep, let's pull back up. We need to get closer to those trailers. Let's drag it all the way back over here. So we need more turning radius there. Guys, we're gonna get it. We didn't make it this far not to get it. I'm not getting at the right cut. Almost close to that trailer. Thank you. on, baby. Let's see where we're at. Okay, cool. We're good to go. So now we just need to come up. A lot of getting out on this one. Now we can use our left side to our advantage. Here we go. That's why you just don't give up. Even though we had it, we're gonna get it nice and straight. All right, let's check that out. Let's see if that got it, guys, to my satisfaction. And we can straighten it up just a little bit more. That's not how we deliver our goods. Let's come up. We gotta get it right or not at all. How we roll. That's much better. All right, let's go ahead and take a look at this. And whatever it is, we're gonna live with it. All right, that's a little bit more straighter to our standard. So let's go ahead and the lights off and shut the engine down, folks. And we are officially complete with our job. We did it. Traveled from Palm Springs, California to Oxnard, Ubered to LA to get our truck, and then back to Oxnard all the way to Hobbs, New Mexico. Couldn't have done it without you guys on board either craft. Once again, from the Dre Sanchez YouTube channel, appreciate you guys for staying on board, and let's look forward to our next journey, wherever that may bring us. Until then, take care, God bless, stay safe. Out here on the Dre Sanchez YouTube channel.